kind of a seminar, I asked Sathya, can you please give me 10 minutes? Because I want to just put a word, as still vitiligo is a stigma in India. And what we are working is a genetic analysis. If you can give me 10 minutes, I'll just present one case. And I will not take much of your time. I'm just presenting one case on the genetic analysis, that how is vitiligo combined with the genes. We cannot correct the genes. We have to stop the mutation of the genes so that there is no vitiligo. So this is a gene therapy for predictive diagnosis and preventive personalized precision medicine for vitiligo. And see, it is a straight non-invasive non-drug therapy. Even in the pregnancy itself, we can analyze that this gene is there in the baby and this is responsible for vitiligo. So you stop the gene mutations. Where is the enter here? Or we all know what is vitiligo. We have the technology. Ah, the animation we can see later on. This is what is now finally termed as autoimmune disorder. We have been speaking in Unani medicine or Ayurveda medicine, what I call it as mainly as traditional medicine, it's autoimmune. And then the genetic linkage. Immediately when a person comes with vitiligo, we ask, kisi ko tha ghar pe? Who is it? You don't ask from when is it. You ask who had it. You know, indirectly you are following the questions. You never ask when did it start. Kisi ko tha ghar pe? That's the first question in the clinic. And then you ask, acha pe theek hai. That is autoimmune disorder. Then the third one is, isko cure karna mushkil hai, lekin hum try karte hai. Then you get the fourth point. Then you say the next one, it is very harmful. But this is vitiligo, what you're seeing is just a syndrome. There is an autoimmune disorder which is behind. Okay. I put this picture of the cow. Because when we said about, there's a sound also coming. When we said about vitiligo, you know, you see the melanin deficiency on the skin. That's just a melanin deficiency. But when you get this milk, pasteurization, non-pasteurization, that immediately gives you what it is. This is how it is, the untreated one. Just three slides. I've taken the gene sample of this. We evaluated it as vitiligo. I'll just skip the animation again because I'll load it on the website, you can see. What is it happening? You have the melanocytes destroyed, and the melanocytes are specific differentiation genes, and they are dichrome genes. I'm not sure why the videos are not playing. Just a second. Let me see. We have two types of genetic links, that is segmental and non-segmental. When we say segmental and non-segmental, we go deeper into the chromosomes and the mitochondria. Then again, in this segmental, we see that males are the carrier and dominant characteristics of vitiligo. It doesn't come from the female. Agar ladki ko hai, uski shaadi nahi ho rahi hai, phir bhi uske bacche ko nahi aayega. It will come to the next generation. But ladke ko hai, the next generation ko aayega hi aayega. This was the main reason. Many of them, even if they die today, unfortunately, they put salt to bury them. Unfortunately, they put it in the copper turning to burn them. But this is not needed. They are also same like us. So I will load all this animation so you are there. The polygenic nature, multifactorial inheritance, autosomal and not linked to race or sex, linked to the autosome immunities. So that's how the genetic linkages are. Wait, I bring the next. This is the melanocyte. How does the melanocyte look? When you look at it, you have the nucleus and the endoplasmic reticulum. We are taking the endoplasmic reticulum, the just two strands below, putting it for the genetic fingerprinting. The chromosome T613 and T617 are responsible. So in the blood, when you have this sequencing, we get it out. This is the curing vitiligo effects. Long and difficult process, rarely 100% effective on the individual. Sorolene is just giving the superficial skin melanin excretion, and then you're getting the color. But for a long term, you have to stop the genetic mutations. And it is easy to find here because you have the sun. In Germany, you don't have the sun. Even if you give babchi for even 6 weeks, you don't see. But you put the person under the sunlight, you can see the changes. Without Babchi also, we are just giving the physical and the chemical methods and cosmetics. Most of it is going for cosmetics and depigmentation. Psychological counseling, we miss that in India. Yes? Major psychological counseling, we miss that in India. You know, when they see a lady with a vitiligo hand, they don't take anything from her. Lips, they put hardcore lipsticks. Eyes, they try to cover half front. I watched the movie, when new movie has come, just only for this, what is it? Kuch Alfaz, the way, right? Something like that. It's all with a girl who has a vitiligo and only the words. But this movie has been taken by the European Union to promote it in Europe, saying that no more in Asia, it's a stigma. That's huge for industry is cosmeceuticals. Again, you can, I just have from, I think you all have done the research, even I'm telling Vahid bhai, you have done so much on vitiligo. Can we bring it out as one product in Make in India? At least the external application, at least boiling the babchi in coconut oil, decentralizing it, putting it into small ampules or gel capsules and bringing out. That is what I try to do, giving the patients. I mean, I don't call them patients, giving the people. Then the chemical treatment options here. All of the animations are not working here. So corticosteroids is not the first chance. So now this is how it is. These are the HLA class 1, HLA class 2, PTP, N2. You can see in vitiligo, all of them will be positive. These are the spots of the genetics. So when we get the spottings, you can see irritable bowel. That's why you immediately ask, is there something with your gastrium? You immediately ask, you can see rheumatoid arthritis, you can see autoimmune thyroid, but you can see the spotting for the genetics there. These are the identifying the association with other autoimmune diseases. That's why we call vitiligo as a syndrome or a sign. Then you have physical treatments here. Tattooing, the skin grafting, I don't think so in India, but so using blisters, autologous melanocyte transplantation. That's the latest. Okay. So this is how we do the melanocyte transplantation. Embed the melanocytes in the dermal papilla. So it is subcutaneous patch which is given. Especially we give it to the nails because nails are the absorbing pigments. And then you have in this, we trigger the JAK1 and STAT. That's a skin cell which triggers the production of melanocyte from the nails. So this is done on the nails. This is a high-end extract of babchi again. This is only the component extracted, that is CD8T cell from babchi. So that's like putting a nail polish. So nail polish, you don't have vitiligo on your hands. Usually in the winter because we don't have it. So these are the some of the things. So that's how it triggers. You can see the melanocyte down here. I don't have a pointer. Then you can see the JAK inhibitors. It inhibits the process which produces melanin and we increase it. So you can see the last melanoblast moving up. This is the innate immune cell. You can see how it increases the immunity. These are the references. So I'm just, okay, we have the references there. These are all the references. I have loaded this on the testimonial site, one of the whole case on this, so it's there. Oh, over here. One second. Where is it? I think that's there, done. Because the animation videos, the gene mutation which I had taken the copyright is not here. But I'm going to load it because we took the copyrights to load it on the web pages. I'm going to put those animations on there so you can download the animations. Each file is about 4 GB, so you have to download because you have to see how it is mutating. You know, the blocks come down and you have the blocks going up. So when whatever the treatment you are doing, if we can't stop the genetic mutations, you cannot give. One such we are doing right now is watermelon. Watermelon, you know, watermelon has a lot of flavonoid, right? So what we are doing is the watermelon peel, the pink what we eat and the white is given as a scrub. So when you rub it on the skin, it is making the melanocytes produce because it's increasing the blood circulation and it is activating T4. So So it was the first one, and just recently we were having, we did ourselves a small thing. We took out that and we made like oil of it with coconut oil, and we have tried to do that, and that's working because coconut oil is easily absorbing. So I gave you one recipe when it comes, you know, even with the rashes, it just comes in because watermelon peel has itself a healing property. And I think that that's what I tried to finish, saving the time. Is that okay? Yeah. It's going to come on the website.
So
I'm going to put the animations. Yeah, tell me, Doctor.
No, just I want to ask that whether it has been come in the public domain or not. In public domain it's available or not?
In Germany we take years to publish a paper, probably 5 years to for a paper to come out. Now, not only this, we are bringing the blood cell tomography for this, where we pick up the cells of the blood and the plasma is sent to the genetic analysis. In the cellular level itself, I'm finding out what is deficient. So now this is the first beginning of what we are seeing with vitiligo. Our samples are, we get the samples from Minnesota and Frankfurt right now in two labs where we are picking up the samples. We are seeing the cellular changes and the genetic changes. To publish it, we have to look further. We want to look into the mitochondrial changes. So we are now working on the mitochondrial changes. Because, you know, publishing this data and then we find that in the mitochondrial changes, maybe there is another autoimmune gene which is also triggering it, because now it is both the male, I mean the mother and the father, right? So in Germany what is there is we don't know the biological father sometimes. So that's why we don't know what the baby is carrying. So we have about 7 lakh carrier biomarker genes, which it's like a template for almost 3 weeks which we work out, and we say, okay, this gene is responsible for this. As simple as your eye color, nose, hair. So when they know that this is responsible and it is coming to the second or the third, we used to do that, okay, if the father is having a vitiligo, bete ko aayega. The first, agar first ladka hota hai, automatically it was punched. Seal laga hua hota hai, ki agar iska chacha ko hai, to isko aayega hi aayega. Then agar ye isko nahi aa raha, to iski beti ko aayega. So we knew that because we know the family. In Europe, we don't know the family. So that's where we got these markers. And I was brought in because we wanted the gene mutations to be stopped right with the food and nutrition level basis of it. And where, you know, we have requested maybe 1,000 times to the Indian government to give us the research papers related to Babchi. And I have been again and again asking CCRM, you have done 17 years of research. You know, in Aligarh, they have also named it as one of the syndrome with a person's name, the funding. But we did not get a single copy to say that, okay, this is a research data from the Indian side. Let us put it for this thing. Where did all that work go? I am just asking her, where did all that work go? Why don't we bring it out into a validation? We need to reach out the masses. Even now, wo chupa dete hain. They try to close, they try to do this. It's not open. Why don't we campaign in the public, as a public health, saying that, okay, they don't touch, they don't hug, they don't eat with them. This is in the villages in India, even now. I get a lot of patients, whenever I come to India, they said, please, didi, aap is bachchi ko dekh lo, aapne mera kiya hai, usko karo, iski shaadi nahi ho rahi hai. They come early morning at 5 o'clock, don't allow me even to sleep for a few hours, I am there at home. You know, I cannot talk to you, the social stigma they have even now. Recently, just 5 days back, somebody died who had vitiligo, somewhere it was little, here. They put 4 bags of salt when they were to give her their last rites. Why 4 bags of salt with only less? Nahi wo agle 4 janamon tak aayega. I mean, Islam mein janam hi nahi hai, to 4 janamon ka kahan aayega? Now they're saying, now this daughter, because she died and unki beti hai, uske bachche ko hai, ye kaise aayega? You know, why don't you have platforms like CCRM, you have hall, you have everything, why don't you invite the people, the community people? Most important is our mosque. Maybe one poster of this, whatever the data you want, I can give you. They are reading it. I'm not saying this is something a crime, but why have to fight with this? That's where I took this as a chance and a platform. Actually, I'm using Sathya's group to send this message.
If you are doing research in vitiligo and all that, So on this platform, would you like to suggest some preventive measures for the general masses?
For what? For vitiligo?
For prevention of vitiligo and all that.
See, vitiligo is just a, what do we call, like a sinus symptom, you know. You have to stop the melanocyte getting, you have to make the melanocyte active to produce melanin. Abhi there is a history of vitiligo in the family. You are expected to that with a genetic linkage. How do you prevent it? You only have to see what stops according to the person. I cannot say, okay, I'm going to treat you and this person is eating chicken in the morning, chicken in the afternoon, chicken in the evening. I cannot stop that person to give anything when they are not controlling the diet. Now you're saying one person, like for me. If you tell me that, ma'am, you are supposed to eat biryani now, I will say no, it is to my person. But if you can say somebody else, biryani, he will ask which biryani, Kashmiri biryani, Hyderabadi biryani, or, you know, Ambur biryani. Which one I have to prevent? Prevention, again, is a misconcept what you are building in public health. It comes to personalized medicine. That's where precision medicine is coming. Every person is unique, like your eyes, like your nails, like your... I remember Dr. Bashir, he gave his interview in 2003 when we made a documentary for BBC. As he was sitting there, I recollected, even for the diabetic wound, even when he said that how to do, insan say from one person, the dose changes. Even if it is the same formula, the dose changes according to the person. I'm speaking about 18 years back when I was a student in BUMS for final year. I think we had come for your conference, Dr. Fazal's conference, and he took us to Nizamia College, and I still remember that. So now we are having genes to prove from one person to another person. So how can I say overall preventive? What could be preventive to you would be the treatment to him. How can I say? So it has to be modulated. It has to be speculated. We have communities. We have mosques. We all gather for one Quran reading. Why can't we gather to disseminate the knowledge of this? You know, why do we have to go to somebody else for counseling? Taking our children to do a counseling for some counselor, why can't we sit with our children and see what's happening? But not only vitiligo, even you have the white discoloration of the lips because they are biting the lips of stress. And that is mistaken for vitiligo. Lipstick, we just apply the lipstick, the white thing is not going. It's because of the mouth ulcers, vitamin C deficiency. Simple vitamin C deficiency, just giving lemon juice or orange peel 4 days, they will not have mouth ulcers and that white patches on the lips will go because it is vitamin C.
Okay, are you satisfied, sir? Okay, right. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
The question jo hai, our young generation ke liye bhi hai jo research kar rahi hai. Jee. Un log Unani ke students hai. Jee. Main to abhi tak bhi Unani ka student samajhta hu apne aap. Jitna research bahut bura hai.
जो
टर्मिनोलॉजी यूज हो रही है, मिसाल के तौर पे मैडम ने विटिलिगो को इस्तेमाल किया, तो वेस्टर्न कंट्री का आदमी पूछेगा कि भाई जिस सिस्टम के साथ तालमेल रखते हैं क्या उस सिस्टम में कोई टर्मिनोलॉजी नहीं है
जी?
उसकी टर्मिनोलॉजी को हम क्यों अवॉइड करने जा रहे हैं? हमारी आइडेंटिटी कहाँ रहेगी? हम जितनी बातें बोल रहे हैं, हमारे संस्थान जितने भी काम कर रहे हैं, ये प्रीफर कर रहे टर्मिनोलॉजी ऑफ मॉडर्न मेडिसिन.
यस,
बट दे डोंट वांट टू फॉलो, दे डोंट वांट टू मेंशन देयर ओन टर्मिनोलॉजी.
एग्जैक्टली.
तो इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि हमारे सब्जेक्ट में, हमारे सिस्टम में कोई टर्मिनोलॉजी मौजूद नहीं है, इसलिए वहां से मुस्तार ले लिया उसको लेके जो प्रेजेंट कर. तो मेरी ये ख्वाहिश है मेरे तमाम जो है जूनियर से, क्योंकि मैं भी तालिब इल्म हूँ, इस बात को जहन में रखना है कि जब भी आप कोई काम करने जा रहे हैं तो अपनी आइडेंटिटी को बरकरार रखिए. यू आर यूनानी पर्सन, यू शो यस आई एम यूनानी पर्सन, बट यू कैन प्रेजेंट द मॉडर्न टर्मिनोलॉजी एंड इन द सिनेरियोस यू प्रेजेंट योर सिस्टम टर्मिनोलॉजी. ये इंपॉर्टेंट बात है. दूसरी बात मैडम भाई, विटिलिगो के अंदर तो जो बातें हो रही है, यूनानी अतिब्बा ने लिखा है कि जिगर के अंदर जब खराबी पैदा हो जाती है तो स्किन इरप्शन आते हैं, स्किन डिजीज आते हैं.
एग्जैक्टली.
देयर इज अ रिलेशन इन बिटवीन लिवर एंड स्किन एलिमेंट्स. तो हम जब रिसर्च करने जा रहे हैं, जितने पिगमेंटेशन की बात हो रही है, मेलानोसाइट की बात हो रही है, जो सौदे से ताल्लुक रखने वाली बात है,
जी.
लेकिन लीवर का कहीं तस्करा मौजूद नहीं होता
जी? बिल्कुल.
लीवर का क्या पर्टेड रोल है वो मालूम नहीं हो रहा, और यूनानी तिब में लीवर से मुतालिक जितनी दवाएं बयान की गई है और उसूल इलाज में भी बात लिखी गई है कि आप उसूल इलाज में सबसे पहले जिगर की इस्लाह करो।
यस,
मॉडर्न साइड पे यूनानी लिटरेचर, मॉडर्न लिटरेचर में पूरे लीवर के बारे में तमाम तफसीलात मौजूद हैं, लेकिन देयर इज नो ट्रीटमेंट।
I got what I wanted. Yes, exactly. देखिए, जब हम बर्स लिखते हैं ना, the Indian government has not given this international terminology. इन्होंने पूरी खा गई. When a vitiligo leucoderma, it's a huge chapter. When we put that, see, when I'm trying to put this, our own Indian government is stopping. Now I will take it. I did not put it deliberately. I wanted somebody to recommend. Now I'll say this was a recommendation during the event.
We are not burned because we are having right to show our identity.
I have a reference to put now. That was my main reason to present it. Yeah, we've done it.